on MTV, where you get to talk to your favorite artists live. Call us up. Our toll-free number is 1-800-344-ROCK, which is 1-800-344-7625. Wow. Tonight, our guest, Jerry Dixon of Warrant. Hi, Jerry.
How you doing, Martha?
Welcome to Rockline.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
And we have, before we get into conversation with you, we have put together a little piece about Warrant. Let's take a look.
The critics that don't get Warrant are not the people who are going out and buying the record and coming to the concerts anyways. They're not the people that the music is good for. The band has a lot more depth lyrically and musically than people give credit for. I don't think all music has to have any political significance or a deep religious meaning. I mean, you can have fun rock and roll. It was made to be a fun video, period. And some people didn't get the joke. It went over their head. They thought that we were being degrading to women in general. And I love my mother. With Uncle Tom's Cabin, we had an opportunity to do something I think is very movie-esque. As time goes on down the road, as we make more records, I think it'll become more apparent to people who are into the band that the band's a multi-dimensional band.
Some people took the cherry pie concept a little too seriously. You were doing a live show in Europe, and what happened? Got a string?
Well, we ate cherry pie. What happened was the producer of the show, Europe's got a whole different mentality than America, so she thought the record was called Cherry Pie. So when the guys are on stage live, we're going to bring about 20 cherry pies into the crowd and pass them out, and we're on stage live while she's in the crowd passing these pies out, going, throw them at the band, throw them at the band, and we took it as an insult, but it was supposed to be fun, you know, they call it big fun over there.
Did you just freak out when people started throwing?
Completely. We were professionals, though. We only knocked one guy out.
Uh-oh.
No, Steve got hit in the face. And
get rid of the cherry pie.
Steve's a very, very quiet guy in the band, and he freaked. He lost it.
Wow.
Got up, threw a stick at some guy.
That doesn't feel good.
Yeah, and then they had these red noses that they put on, and we thought it was because we stunk, but I guess it was like a compliment over there.
Oh, boy. Well, no, Jerry, we won't
throw
any kind of pies at you tonight, I promise.
At least we didn't name the record, like, Rock Pie or something.
Poison Dart Pie. All right, from Indianapolis, Indiana, our first phone caller tonight, we've got a stack of them. Chris, you start us off. You're talking with Jerry Dixon.
Hello.
Hello. With your first album, Such a Success, was your second album an album to slap critics in the face or just make them mad?
Well, critics are critics are critics, really. We don't go in the studio to do a record to please critics. We do it to please ourselves and the fans. So we really, that's the on the back burners. Nobody really thinks about that. We just tried to make a better record than the first one. Quality of the songs were better. The production was better. The playing was better. So we just tried and bettered ourselves as musicians, really. We didn't write the record for critics to, you know, throw things at us, because it doesn't really matter. The more bad critics you have out there, the more records you sell.
Oh, is that a fact?
Yeah.
That's an interesting thing.
That's the way we look at it.
I've always heard it said that Led Zeppelin never got a good review.
That's
so
right.
You never know what you're going to get.
Right. That's why they call it rock and roll.
Donna is on the line from Gardner, Massachusetts. Donna, say hello to Jerry.
Hello, Jerry.
How you doing, Donna?
All right, how are you?
Oh, Donna, I'm doing good. What's happening?
Not much.
What's on your mind, Donna?
Okay, was it very emotional for you to do a show for the troops and how much it meant to you?
Oh, it was very, very emotional. You know, this was at a time when all this stuff was going down in the Gulf War, and we got asked to do a free show for the families of the people that were over there, and it was it wasn't a big press thing, which was nice. It was basically to get all the families and the people that were home united just to have a good time. And it was very emotional because after the show, we went to the barracks with the guys, and they got us completely hammered. And those guys know how to drink more than us. They made us look bad. But, you know, we started walking down the corridor to leave, and they started chanting, USA, USA. And I just got goosebumps. It was great. It was
a fun
thing I'll never forget.
All right, Donna, thank you very much for the call. And Linda's waiting from Vista, California to speak with Jerry Dixon of Warrant. Hi, Linda. Welcome to Rockline.
Hi, Hi.
How you doing, Linda?
How you doing, Jerry?
I'm feeling good.
What's your question?
On your album,
True.
Cherry Pie.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, on your album, Cherry Pie.
Yeah.
The song titled Cherry Pie.
Yeah.
Wasn't going to be on the album. Is that true?
No, it was a complete mistake. No, actually, the whole record was recorded, and the president of CBS wanted one more song, so we kind of made a bet with Jani to say, you know, I bet you couldn't write a real anthemish song in one night. And Janie's very competitive. He said, okay, you know, watch this. So he went home and came in the next day to the studio after the record was all done. We were mixing down, and said, check this song out. You know, it's called Cherry Pie. And we went, Cherry Pie? And the song just remained like that. We had to set all the gear back up, and we ended up calling the record Cherry Pie. And that was the first single, and it was real spontaneous, so it was real fun.
What would you have called the album if it wasn't for Cherry Pie?
Hi, Mom. It was going to be called Vertical Smiles.
Betty is on the line from Memphis, Tennessee. Thank you, Linda, by the way, for your call. Memphis, Tennessee has got Betty waiting to talk to Jerry Dixon. Hi, Betty. Go ahead.
Hey, Jerry. I love you.
Oh, I love you too, Betty. How you doing?
I'm doing great. Now.
Yeah?
Okay, well, I know the music scene in L.A. is really big, and lots of new bands go to L.A. to try to make it big. And
yeah.
I'm wondering, how hard is it for bands in L.A. to get a record deal? Because, like, in Memphis, we have a Memphis Producer Showcase.
Yeah.
Every year, producers come out and check out the music scene. And Roxy Blue, whom you guys know?
Roxy Blue, yeah. That's hey, guys, Todd, year. The guys, yeah.
And they're getting ready to go to L.A. But how
know.
Are bands in L.A. get a record deal?
Big plug for Roxy Blue.
Really?
We helped them, okay? They got signed, and, you know, it's hard, but it's the place to be, really, because all the labels have a branch here, and as opposed to having somebody fly out to Memphis, you know, each time your band plays, even though you have to pay like $2,000, which I think really sucks.
Is that how much it is?
Yeah.
So what if you're a struggling band and you can't?
I couldn't believe it. Well, I have some friends that played the other night, and they didn't sell all their tickets, so the promoter took some of their gear.
Wow,
and it's really tough. But you know, there's people say there's a lot of LA bands, but most of the bands, like especially Warrant, you know, Jani and Steve are from Ohio. Joey was born in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Eric's from Nebraska. So everybody moves out here. So you know, it's tough. But if you have what it takes, this is the place to be, and you can rise above it. You know, look at all the bands that have.
Yeah, for sure. Okay, Betty, thank you for calling. And before we take a break, we have a moment to speak with Bill, who's calling from Escondido, California. Bill, you're on.
Escondido. How you doing, Bill?
Pretty good. How you doing?
Good. What's happening?
Not much. I wanted to know, how did you and the other members of the band feel when Jani did the solo version of I Saw Red?
Oh, it was actually cool because we got to kick back and relax. It was no big deal to us. We don't have any ego problems within the band. It was done, everything we do is for a reason. It was done because the song was doing very well, and MTV wanted to run a different version of it to keep it alive, you know, because the song was out almost 3 months, and the video was kind of getting burnt out. So if that's all it took, we said fine. Plus, it was done in Tennessee, in one of the oldest graveyards in America, which kind of freaked me out, so I didn't want to go near that. But that was the reason, you know, and it came out great, and it served the purpose, really.
Bill, thank you very much for calling, and we've got a lot more calls to go, and we'll be back in just a moment. Our toll-free number tonight is 1-800-344-ROCK, which is 1-800-344-7625. Jerry Dixon of Warrant is here. Don't go away.
Play some hacky stuff.
A lot of people didn't vote in November. A lot more weren't even registered. If you think that keeps the politicians up at night, forget it. A lot of them don't even want you to vote. That's why they make registering so hard. Call your senators. Call your representative. Call them and tell them that you should be able to register. When you get a driver's license, you should be able to register by mail. It's our country. It's time we took it back.
Welcome back to Rockline on MTV. Our guest tonight, Jerry Dixon of Warrant. You can call us up right now if you have a question. Our toll-free number is 1-800-344-ROCK. Jerry, what happened with the tour with Poison?
Good question.
How did that come down?
Well, the whole thing kind of got off on the wrong foot with the Jani and Brett similarities. And, you know, we kind of opted our band not to really, you know, talk bad about any other band. It just, there was some personal problems, and that really couldn't be worked out, that started hindering our live show and getting in the way of what we did on stage. And when that happened, you know, it was just time to leave it. You know, they're, you know, doing their own thing. We're doing ours. We're really not out to, you know, criticize them or anything.
That's kind of too bad, because as I understand it, you guys were friends for a long time.
Yeah, it was just things change, you know.
Things change. Well, we have Jerry Dixon right here on Rockline tonight, and that's for sure. That'll stay the same. And we've got Veronica waiting to talk to us from Alexandria, Louisiana. Hi, Veronica. Say hello to Jerry.
Hey, dude.
Hey, dude.
What's up?
Not much. How you doing?
All right. Okay, well, here's my question. Did you guys come up with the concept for Ode to Tipper Gore because you feel strongly about censorship?
Yeah. Do you like that?
Yeah.
All right. It's a lovely little ballad for those of you that haven't heard it yet.
Could you do some of it for us? No, just kidding.
Holy shit. No, just kidding. Yeah, it was actually an engineer put that together from the Dirty Rotten long-form video. It was a bunch of outtakes of the show. And the engineer put it together and played us this tape, and at the same time when the censorship things were going on. So we wanted to be kind of like the first rock band to step up and say, hey, you know, we're going to risk a lot of album sales or whatever it takes to make a statement on this record. So it actually started kind of as a joke, but as time went on, it got serious, and that's why it's on the record.
And you were saying before about bad critics sometimes add to record sales.
That's right.
I kind of think maybe that sticker adds to record sales, too.
They do. They do. Well, next record, we want two stickers.
Double stickers. Thanks, Veronica, for calling. Maggie's waiting from South Bend, Indiana. Maggie, welcome to Rockline.
Hi.
Say hi to Jerry Dixon.
Hi, Jerry. How you doing?
I'm doing good, Maggie. What's going on?
Not much.
Not much? What's on your mind? Talk to me, baby. Come on.
When you guys released Heaven, there was some controversy with the Bay City Rollers.
Oh.
Your opinion on that?
I think that really, it's not, we found out later that it's not actually with the band. It was a songwriter, I believe, that collaborated and wrote a song for them before I was born. And Bay City who? And they're suing us. You know, they waited till the song went almost to number one, and then they said, hey, that adds up here, so let's go after him. But I guess that's one bad thing about America is lawyers and suing each other for stupid reasons like that. So we're still actually fighting it. We're not going to back down. We're, you know, we're going to stick up for what we believe. The song wasn't ripped off. We'd been playing that song 5 years ago in clubs before we were nothing. And what the funny thing is, too, is there was two other bands that tried to sue us for Heaven. In three different states. So that's three bands, three different states, and we stole the song from all of them.
Wow.
So we got that going for us, that everyone kind of attacked us on that song. It was just a moneymaker.
Yeah.
So, but we're it's definitely
kind of
going to fight it. Yeah.
Well, being
come
in
on, Bay City Rollers.
Yeah. Warrant takes on the Bay City Rollers.
Yeah, they want us to pay their mortgage.
Their
come
little
on.
Plaid
that's
shorts.
Not fair.
We have a phone call now from Jani, who's calling us from California. Hi, Jani. Say hello to Jerry.
Hey, Jerry.
Hi, Jani. How you doing?
Dude.
What's up?
I'm the biggest airhead that has ever lived, and you know that already.
I do. Are you out by the pool?
I can't believe this. No, I'm inside. I'm packing away. I'm going, okay, we're going to Japan tomorrow, man. I got my deodorant. I got my cologne. I'm looking over at the clock. I go, well, it's 6 o'clock. That's cool. I got time. I totally forgot about the daylight savings time.
Man, you let me down. I just was saying that you're always late, but never once have you missed a show or anything live. And then I said, I shouldn't have said that.
But
I shouldn't have said that.
Jani.
I'm living proof that Spinal Tap is a true story.
Rock and roll.
Cleveland rock.
Hello, Cleveland.
Jani, daylight savings time took place like a week ago. Have you been late like all week long?
He'll be late to his own funeral.
No, well, Jani, what's your question for Jerry?
I have no idea what to say, except that you know, it's just one of those brain things.
Jani, I think now that you're on Rockline, and you're on Rockline on MTV is a call-in question show, and Jani, you're on the line with Jerry Dixon of Warrant. What's your question?
What's my question?
Go for it.
What are you bringing to Japan and Australia?
Dude, you going to start looking for a new singer, sir?
Yeah, he's right here, man.
Yeah. What's going on?
Jay, why don't you hang on? We're going to take another call, and then we'll come back to you, all right?
Okay.
Hang on while we get Rich from Louisville, Ohio.
We're
going
to get Rich? talk to Rich.
Dirty, rotten,
filthy
stinking Rich, I believe. Go ahead, dirty, rotten Rich.
Cut! Jay, this is live, see?
You're on with Jerry Dixon of Warrant. Go ahead.
Hey, Jerry, what's up?
Not much, Rich. How you doing?
Real good. I just got, a question for you.
That's good.
That's what we're here for. Go for it.
Go ahead.
Based on your experience, how would you treat your opening band, that Warrant's going to be headlining this summer?
That's a great question.
Yeah, that is a great question.
Cross that off my list.
We treat all of our bands the same, really. We really are confident in our show, and we're confident in our ability to do our job. We're not threatened by anybody, so it's always going to be the same, really. Just here's a stage, and get up and try and blow us away.
But does it give you a different perspective, having spent a lot of road time as an opening act? Do you think that it makes you a little bit more aware of what your support act is going through?
Yeah, it definitely does. I think when bands get like that, it cracks me up. It's really kind of a joke that somebody has to, put all these restrictions on you. I think it's just insecurity with a lot of bands. We were out with Motley for 4 months, and they said, hey, here's a stage, try and blow us away, man. We want to watch you every night. We want you guys to be young, and we're going to check it out, and hopefully, it'll, keep us going up here. That was their attitude, as opposed to, other bands' attitudes. We're going to take the Motley route.
Oh, well, that's definitely a good thing to learn from, I think. Let's go the positive route. Thank you, Rich, for calling. Appreciate it. And we have another couple of seconds. We're going to squeeze in Belinda from Newport, Oregon. Belinda, say hi to Jerry Dixon. And you can say hello to Jani, but he's on hold.
He's listening, though.
Go ahead, Belinda. What's your question?
Hi, Jerry.
How you doing, Belinda?
Oh, I'm doing great. How you doing?
I'm doing wonderful.
Well, hi, Jani in California.
At home, packing.
I was wondering, the Uncle Tom's Cabin, if that's a true story, or did you guys got inspired by it,
Well, Jani wrote the song. I think I could answer that for him. It wasn't a true story, but it was kind of dedicated to his father. As Jani was growing up, his father would always tell him stories and really inspired him to use your mind and, paint kind of a, different pictures in your head instead of seeing, the front surface of everything. So it was inspired by that, but it, there were certain things that we kind of heard about that were true. So nothing, it wasn't really contrived of an actual incident. It was just things that we've kind of heard, and so it's kind of half and half, really.
Kind of sparked your imagination
exactly.
That led you
to lead it to that song.
Uncle Tom's Cabin. So thank you very much for the call. Do we still have you, Jani? No. You're watching Rockline on MTV. Tonight's guest, Jerry Dixon from Warrant. We will be right back. Give us a call.
I love
you,
Jani.
This is a serious thing, all right?
Welcome back to Rockline on MTV. If you have a question for Jerry Dixon of Warrant, it's not too late. Call us up, and it's free at that. Call us at 1-800-344-ROCK, which is 1-800-344-7625. Now, we had a phone call earlier from one Mr. Jani Lane. Jani, do we have you on the line?
Yes.
Well, by phone is better than nothing at all. Now,
he's
Jani,
into the phone thing.
Martha, you have my deepest apologies.
That's okay. You owe me one.
You know, I've never, ever slighted MTV in any way, and they told me that they're already threatening never to play another Warrant video.
Oh, no.
No, I'm joking.
Hey, Jani, we saw your Rock the Vote piece a little while ago. Why did you get involved? And tell me about the motor voter bill.
Well, we got involved mostly due to the censorship issue, which is it's a very scary issue to any artist or musician to think that the government or the powers that be can dictate what you say or play on a record. When that happens, music to me will no longer be an art form. And I thought the Rock the Vote was a very positive thing. It was getting people involved who weren't registered to vote or were registered and were not voting to use their power of vote to basically vote out the ultra-conservatives who are pro-censorship. And the motor voter thing, it deals with the driver's license. A lot of people, there's a lot of people moving in the country, changes of address, that kind of thing, applying for a driver's license. What it basically deals with is if you apply for a driver's license, you automatically are applying for voter registration. And that helps because from state to state, the laws that govern registration for voting differ. So if a person moves out of state, it's very confusing how to figure out how to re-register yourself to vote. So
just simplifies the whole process.
Idea. Excuse me?
I said it just simplifies the whole process. You get your license, you register to vote, it's all one quick
thing.
Those
people that are running from the law.
You know, yeah, people that are running
from
the law.
You don't have to stop in and vote.
Absolutely. I mean, it's a pretty staggering figure. Up to 70 million people
that help.
are not registering to vote who have the ability to, and that's a scary thought.
Jani, thank you so much for calling. Good luck in Japan, and please have a good time packing. Watch the show, will you?
All right.
Don't miss the flight tomorrow. 11:30, United, flight 798.
Oh, Jerry.
By the way, Jerry, you're doing a great job, bud.
Thanks, man.
Okay, goodbye, Jani.
All right, bye-bye.
See,
that's
I'm sure...
not in the internationals.
I'm sure nobody's going to be there tomorrow.
Come on down, man.
Give out your whole itinerary.
That's all right.
Amy?
I'm leaving.
Amy's waiting from Rochester, New York. Go ahead, Amy. Say hi to Jerry Dixon. Not on United. Tomorrow.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Amy.
Hi, Amy. She's going to fly to L.A. Yeah. And sit there and wait.
What's your question, Amy?
Hello.
Okay. I have two questions.
Like a little Walkman here. See, that's where I hear her.
Hello?
TV.
It's hard.
Go ahead. I'm
missing
just kidding.
Each other. Go ahead, Amy.
What do you feel makes Warrant different from other hard rock bands?
We're just amazing guys. Now, I don't know. Ask Martha that question. Why are we different from other bands? I don't know. We just try really to be ourselves and not to to sell out in any shape or form with the image or the music. And, you know, but the main thing is probably just the music. People like the songs. That's what it comes down to, you know.
And how many other bands have a lead singer named Jani, who's 6 foot? Four, whatever it is.
Right, 6'6".
Okay. Amy, thank you so much for calling.
Thanks.
And Diana's waiting to talk to us from Watertown, South Dakota. Diana, how are you? Say hello to Jerry.
Hi, Jerry.
How you doing?
Fine.
How's South Dakota?
Oh, great.
You know, I got arrested there for walking out of the parking lot with a beer once.
Oh.
Did you?
Yeah. I'll never forget that. That was boring or something. What's happening?
Huh?
It was a good show up there, though. So what's going on?
Oh, nothing, just sitting around watching you guys.
Yeah?
What's your question?
Are we that boring tonight, or do you have a question?
Yeah.
What is it?
What's your next single and video going to be after Uncle Tom's Cabin?
It's going to be Blind Faith, and that should be out in probably about a month to 5 weeks, and the video is just kind of being worked in right now. We did some live footage, and it's going to be a concept kind of behind Blind Faith. Instead of addressing it towards a girl or something, we're trying to address it just to our fans.
Interesting.
Blind Faith and our fans and stuff like that. But it's in the works right now, so that should be out pretty soon.
Well, good. Thank you for calling. And Les, before you leave, we wanted
okay,
to give you,
ahead,
probably
please.
Never thought that it would happen, but you won the
no
March
way.
Video Madness competition, and we got you the trophy.
Oh, this is great.
Congratulations.
All right, looks like a bowling trophy. Cool.
No, it's basketball because it went along with the
MTV. That's right. God, thanks for everyone for calling in. That's awesome.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful thing. I feel like I just won an Oscar or something. I'd like to thank the Academy.
Don't you dream about that, making your acceptance speech at the Grammys or what?
I like Kevin Costner, though. Okay. Wait, you know, this brilliant guy. Wait, I can't remember anything. I'd like to thank my band members. What were their names?
Okay, Jerry, thank
cool.
you very much. That is it for this edition of Rockline on MTV. Thank you so much. It's
Put it
great.
There. Thank you.
Next week, Brett Michaels of Poison is going to be here. We're going to hear
right.
that kind of a story. And you can call us up. Don't forget, be with us, and we'll see you then.
See ya. Leopard.